नमस्कार डियर स्टूडेंट्स, आई एम विष्णु देवी शर्मा अगेन हियर, वेलकम यू बैक। इन आवर प्रीवियस क्लास वी स्टडीड अबाउट मेकिंग प्लान्स एंड एक्सप्रेसिंग इंटेंशंस, एंड टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू स्टडी अबाउट अ पोएम, द विंड एंड द लीव्स। इट इज अ पोएम रिटन बाय जॉर्ज कूपर। प्लीज डियर क्लास 9 स्टूडेंट्स, please open your English book on page number 3. The Wind and the Leaves by George Cooper. Have you ever heard the name of George Cooper? Please students, say. Okay, George Cooper was an American poet and songwriter. He is best known for his lyrics. He translated the lyrics of German, Russian, Italian, Spanish, and French musical work into English language. He was born on May 4, 1840 in Newark, United States, and he died in 1927. He has written many books, among them Chaplets of Original Hymns, Christmas and Easter Carols, Sunday Schools, etc. are his famous books. Okay, now look at your book. Okay, look over here students, what can you see? There are two pictures. Please say what is happening in the first picture. Please look and try to say what is happening in the first picture. In the first picture, the leaves of the tree is covering with snow. And what is happening in the second picture? In the second picture, the leaves of the trees are falling down on the ground. The leaves' colors are red and brown. The wind and the leaves. Please, students, listen attentively. I am going to read the poem. Come, little leaves, said the wind one day. Come over the meadows with me and play. Put on your dresses of red and gold, for summer is gone and the days grow cold. Soon as the leaves heard the wind's loud call, down they came fluttering one and all. O'er the brown field then they danced and flew, singing the soft little song they knew. Dancing and whirling the little leaves went. Winter had called them and they were content. Soon fast asleep on their earthy beds, the snow laid a coverlet over their heads. Okay students, it is a poem written by George Cooper. It is a lyrical and melodious poem. Literally, it is about a natural interplay between the autumn leaves and the wind. In other words, the poem presents a very common natural happening in different seasons of the year. But the poem, through this general event, carries and underlying meanings which supports and ideas that change is inevitable and certain. The underlying meaning of the poem is change is inevitable and certain. This is the rule of nature which everything should follow. Change is the natural rule. We born, we grow up, and finally. finally we died. That is the natural rule that everyone should accept. Okay. In the poem, the technique of personification has been used. The personification is a figure of speech that is used to offer human quality to non-human objects in literary work. In the poems, wind, leaves, winter, snow, etc. are personified. For example, different words and phrases used in the poem, for example, said the wind one day, the leaves heard the wind's loud call, winter had called them, the snow laid a coverlid, etc. These are the words and phrases used in the poem which indicate the personification technique. Okay, and another technique used in the poem is visualization. It is a technique of creating image to communicate a message. Okay, students, now read the poem again and find out the new words. Please read and underline the new words that you find in the poem. Calm little leaf, said the wind one day, come over the meadows with me and play. Here I think meadow is new for you. Put on your dresses, red and gold. Put on your dresses of red and gold, for summer is gone and the days grow cold. Soon the leaves heard the wind's loud call, down they came fluttering one and all. Please students, guess the meaning. What does fluttering mean? Okay, please guess. I will say the meaning of these words later on. Whirl the brown field. Whirl. Here, what is missing here? Please try to guess. Whirl the brown field. Then they danced and flew, singing the soft little songs they knew. Dancing and whirling the little leaves went. Winter had called them and they were content. Soon fast asleep on their earthy beds, the snow laid a coverlet. What does coverlet mean? Over their head. Okay, students, please guess the meaning of this word coverlet, content, whirling, and fluttering. I hope you have guessed. Now match your guess with the meaning here. Okay, meadow. Look at here. What can you see in the picture? That is grassland. Meadow means grassland, a piece of land covered or cultivated with grass or grassland. Okay, now fluttering. What is the meaning of fluttering? Moving lightly and quickly. Have you ever seen the dried leaves falling from the tall tree on the ground? How they dance, how they move and fall down. Over means over. Here V is missing. Over. Coverlet, a type of bedspread to cover the bed. Laid, placed down in the position of rest. Laid means placed down in the position of rest. And what do you mean by content? Okay, that means satisfied or happy. And whirling means rotating or spinning. Look at the leaves, how they are spinning, rotating. This is the meaning of the word whirling. Okay students, now read again and I'm going to describe you about the poem. Calm little leaf said the wind one day. Who said? The wind said. To whom? To leaves. The wind said the leaves to calm down on the meadows, means on the grassland. With me, here me means who? Here me means wind. The wind called the leaves to calm down with him on the meadow, over the meadow. Why? To play. Put on your dresses of red and gold. That means dresses of red and gold. The leaves, the color of leaves. In summer season, the color of leaves are green. And when summer is gone and autumn is coming and the leaves of the tree become red, yellow, brown and golden. For summer is gone and the days go cold. Soon as the leaves heard the wind loud's call, when the leaves heard the sounds, wind's loud call, down they came fluttering one and all. When they heard the wind's loud call, they came down by fluttering, moving quickly. Over, moving quickly and lightly, over the brown field then they danced and flew. They came down by dancing and they danced and flew with the wind. They became very happy, singing the soft little songs they knew, and they sing the soft little song what they already known or knew. Dancing and whirling the little leaves went. Dancing and whirling. They dance, they whirl, means they spin, and they went. Winter had called them. Then when they had gone, then winter called them. And they were content. Then when the winter called them, and they became happy again. Soon fast asleep on their ordinance. The winter called them and they come and they stop moving and they fall down on the ground and they fast asleep. The snow laid a coverlet. Then when they stop moving, the snow laid a coverlet over their head. Their coverlet means bedspread. Okay students, that is all about the poem. Now I am going to say you some rhyming scheme here. The poem has AABB rhyming scheme. The word day of the first line rhymes with play of the second one. Similarly, gold rhymes with gold. The tone of the poem is happy, means the poet is written this poem in happy mode. Rhyming scheme is the patterns of rhymes at the end of each lines of a poem. Okay, now look at here. Calm little leaves, the wind said the wind one day. Look at there, look over there. Day and play. These are the rhyming words. And in the second stanza, bold and cold are the rhyming words. Put on your dresses of red and gold, for summer is gone and the days grow cold. Gold and cold, these are the rhyming words, but they do not rhyme with the previous lines, day and play. Similarly, call and all. These two are also rhyming word. Call is rhymed with, or call rhymes with all. Similarly, flew rhymes with new, and wind rhymes with contains, bears rhymes with hairs. So these poems has AA, BB, CC, DD type of rhyming scheme. Okay students, now you got the ideas about the poem, poet and the rhyming scheme. Now, please students, turn to next exercise, read and match. Activity 5. Please students, read the poem again and try to match the words with their meanings in column B. Please, I have already shared the meaning of these words. Please students, find out the meaning now. What is the meaning of meadow? Please students, say. Okay, meadow means what? Grassland. Fluttering, moving lightly and quickly. Similarly, content means satisfied, and coverlet, bedspread. Now move to next exercise, read and answer. Read the poem again and answer the following questions. What did the wind ask the leaves to do? Please students, read and try to find out the answer. How do the leaves look when they are whirled and ready to drop? Why were the leaves so satisfied to calm down? When did the snow lay the bedspread over them? Okay, please students, now tell. What did the wind ask the leaves to do? The wind asked the leaves to calm down and play with him. How do the leaves look when they are whirled and ready to drop? The leaves look red and golden when they are whirled and ready to drop. Why were the leaves so satisfied to come down? The leaves were so satisfied to come down because the winter had called them. When did the snow lay the bedspread over them? When the leaves stop moving and fall asleep on the ground, the snow laid the bedspread over them. Now students, find the words that rhyme with the following words, that they, cold, all, flew, bears. What are the rhyming words? You have to find out. You know, I think you have known about it. Day rhymes with, please students say, what is the rhyming word of day? Play. Cold, gold. Okay, I think you can do it. Okay, your homework is exercise 5, 6 and 7. This much for today. Please students, do this at your home. Don't go out. Stay safe. Thank you. Namaste.